You got your scary curl. That's the Jesus I'm talking about. They call Jesus the Son of Man. How many in the audience have heard Jesus referred to as the Son of Man? Let me see your hand. The Son of Man. Be honest. Black or white. Be honest for once. Son of Man. He's not called the Son of a Spirit. He's called the Son of Man. The Son of Man, if he's not of man and woman, and woman not of him. What is a spirit? We studied etymology to turn spirit out of spiritus, and we find that it is the animating and vital principle in man and woman, credited with the faculties of thought, action, and emotion, and often conceived as an immortal entity. Look, you have a higher self and a lower self. Don't think this is a ridiculous position to take, the position that I have taken. You have a higher self and a lower self. Your higher self is divine and spiritual. Your lower self is matter and material, but you are the essence of God, and God is the essence of you. He's in you, rests, remains, abides, and moves through you.
I guess I should leave this.
For the purpose of questions, we're going to kind of go down the panel here. I'm going to start, and I'll have a few. First of all, Dr. Muhammad, I have a little problem with your use of logic here. When we're talking about unity is when God can act. God has acted in the past, correct?
Correct that God has acted in the past?
Correct.
God has acted in the past.
Thank you. Have we ever had complete unity upon this earth?
My statement was one of the clearest manifestation of God's power, and I spoke of the clearest manifestation of God's power being in the unity of his people.
Okay.
Clearest manifestation of his power. The scripture says that we see through a glass darkly, and that we prophesy in part. So that means that we are not seeing the clearest manifestation of that power now.
So that's why we can't understand him as a man.
That's why the scripture says that God's coming would be after the workings of the devil. That the devil would have a certain period to rule, and God would allow the devil that period to rule. So not only is God man and woman, but the devil is man and woman.
Now that we've established that the devil is man and woman, would you like to tell me that a man and woman created in the name of God, and why they are such a perfect being, and why the devil has taken such a position?
I didn't understand your question, sir.
If God presents his image and we can put our image within man and we take his power and the human mind is fantastic, a great way of creating happiness on earth, we have the ability to have unity, how can the devil have this power as well? Aren't you admitting that God and man both have limitations?
Well, actually, what we are witnessing here is the fact that we are free moral agents. God has an active will, and he has a permissive will. And he has permitted a certain period. None of us in this auditorium can deny that a period of evil and wickedness has reigned throughout the earth and is still reigning. So whether God is spirit or man, there must be something that is not clearly understood here, because the devil, Satan, has been ruling according to what we have been undergoing as the
okay.
People on the planet.
I can buy that. Now, real quickly, and then I'll pass over to Joe. Are you taking the position that God is indeed a man, yet can be a spirit, man, or woman all at the same time?
Well, Jesus, according to Scripture, came to dwell among men and women here on earth. And he represented God in man and man in God. And if Jesus is a sign for us, I'm talking about that black Jesus. If Jesus is a sign for us, then I think we should take him just for that. And that lets us know our divine potential too. Romans, the first chapter, says that Jesus was the son of Joseph according to the flesh and declared to be the son of God according to the spirit of holiness. Declared to be the son of God according to the spirit of holiness. Are you Catholic?
No.
Are you Catholic?
That was irrelevant to this question.